We went from the tallest kid to the shortest. Thank you very much. Greetings, brothers and sisters. My name is Heidi Wellman, and I'm from Marlborough, Massachusetts. In fact, I'm the only candidate from Massachusetts. I graduated from Rockland High School in 1983 with honors, and from Wheaton College in 1987 with a degree in political science. My concentration was in international policy. My minor was in Russian language and literature. I've spent my whole life preparing for this moment. I am not a career politician. I did not work my way up. I served on local boards like all of you have. I was on the Zoning Board of Appeals in Rockland. I was chairman of the Historical Commission in Abington, and I was on the Board of Health in Coleraine. I have lived throughout the state and understand the subtle nuances of the culture within our state. I know this state very well, and I am one of you. I am your mother, your sister, your cousin. I am one of you. Unlike Elizabeth Warren, the incumbent, who's an outsider, she claims to be working for the people, but instead her net worth is in excess of $8 billion, and she is the 28th richest senator in the country at this moment. When I was 12 years old, I told my father that I wanted to be a politician, and he said, "Why?" He said, "You cannot run for office unless you have a clear platform. Unlike the other candidates that might confuse you with smoke and mirrors, I have a very solid platform that I have spent a lifetime developing. And this platform is something that is universal. It isn't going to get old. It isn't for the moment. It's not the fad of the week. My platform is based on core Republican values of minimal government, limited taxation, and the individual rights. I believe in term limits. When I decided to run in January 2017 because Elizabeth Warren said that she could not work with this administration, I said, "Wait a minute, we don't get to pick and choose who we work with. This is your job, we hired you, and you can be replaced." Through term limits, we can remove the dynasties in office, the career politicians. I tell you, I have not been a career politician and do not intend to become one. I believe in a citizen legislature, which is comprised of non-career politicians, and limit the scope of their influence with better qualified candidates. I have signed a contract with candidates which is based on three methods of minimizing kleptocracy in this country. The first part is through election reform. We need to get the big money out of politics. Now, lots of people say that, but they don't really practice it. I can tell you that my campaign has spent and raised $10,000, and it has been entirely self-funded because I believe in myself and the people who are with me are entirely volunteers. A good leader is able to motivate people and not pay them off. Through election reform, we will have better and more frequent candidates who are from the people. The second part of this candidates with a contract is anti-corruption. Once a term is over, a legislator should not be allowed, and anybody in their family should not be allowed, to be a lobbyist for a minimum of 7 years. And finally, transparency and accountability. This part of my platform is about pay increases. In this omnibus spending bill, you might have noticed that the Senate and House gave themselves a pay increase. We need to stop these automatic pay increases. I don't get an automatic pay increase every year. My bonuses and my pay raise is meritorious, and it should be with our members of the Senate. The average rank and file member of the U.S. Senate earns $174,000 a year. That is 330% of the median income of 52,000 in this country. We need to cap that at 330% and prevent further pay increases. Furthermore, by making pay increases meritorious for every $1 that Joe Average earns, the legislator can then earn $3.30. But for every $1 we lose in our pay, the legislator also loses $3.30. That's fair. It is also fair to expect that they work for their living. We should expect them to provide proof of a 40-hour work week. More is good, but a minimum of 40 hours. Now, unlike other contracts the candidates may tell you about, this contract that I signed has teeth in it. Because you need accountability from me. If I, as a person who has signed the contract, does not initiate or support any legislation for these three items, I will voluntarily resign. You know that I will work for you, and the only climate change we need is in the Senate. I ask you to vote for me so that I can proceed into the primary, because I will work for you, and we need to make that Senate work for us. Lastly, I believe in the protection of individuals. This is a core value of Republicanism. I believe that we have the right to carry guns. I believe in the rights of the unborn because they are alive. They're an individual that needs protection. It's not a matter of the choice of the mother. There's also a father and there's a child. So I will protect the rights of the unborn child. And as a Republican, we need to develop, from our candidates, we need to develop some payback. As your candidate, as your U.S. Senator, when my term has ended, I promise you to return here and work for the party and work for you within the state of Massachusetts to develop political programs and new candidates, to teach them, the new candidates, how to govern properly. Thank you, my name is Heidi Wellman.